Hello and welcome to my channel, Medicine with Dr. Moran. I'm Dr. Keith Moran. I've had quite a number of questions wondering about blood types and COVID-19. This video is going to look at two things, whether somebody's more likely to catch COVID and whether they're more likely to be hospitalized based on their blood type. I think a lot of the questions have to do with an early report from China suggesting that the blood type A was associated with increased susceptibility and blood type O was associated with reduced susceptibility to coronavirus infection. I've put a link to this study that I'm going to talk about below. Now, subsequent small studies from Italy as well as Spain reported that blood type A was associated with an increased risk of severe COVID-19. And blood type O was associated with a reduced risk. Follow-up observational studies from Boston and New York did not confirm any specific associations between any of the different blood groups and disease. The authors of this particular study I'm going to tell you about did this because they wanted to independently test whether a certain blood type is associated with greater susceptibility to the infection, or if you get the infection, whether it's associated with more severe COVID-19 disease. Now, this study was done in Utah, Idaho, and Nevada. It was based on records from 24 hospitals and 215 clinics. The study was done prospectively starting in March 2020 and carried on all the way through November 2020. They have an extensive database which was searched for people who were tested for the virus and had a recorded blood type. In total, they looked at all individuals who were tested for the coronavirus, which was 107,796 individuals, of which 11,468 individuals had a positive PCR test. They compared patients with a positive PCR test in each blood type group to people with negative results. Now, here are the results. Of the 11,468 people that had a positive result, 39.6% were blood type A versus 9% with blood type B versus 3.2% with blood type AB and 48.1% with blood type O. Now, if you compare those numbers to the people who had negative PCR tests, you'll notice that there are very similar percentages noted on the chart. These were not statistically different. Thus, one can say that blood group does not have anything to do with susceptibility to actually acquiring this coronavirus infection. Next, they looked at all the positive test results to see whether there was a difference in blood groups to the likelihood of being hospitalized versus not being hospitalized. This chart demonstrates these results. As you can see, there's no significant difference for each blood type. For example, blood type A had 39% whether you're hospitalized or not. Blood type B, 9% hospitalized or not. Blood type AB, 3% in both groups. And blood type O was 48 versus 49%. None of those values were significantly different statistically. They then looked at all the positive test results and looked at who ended up in the ICU versus hospitalized patients who did not need to go to the ICU. This chart did not demonstrate any significant differences either. The study authors indicate that the population they studied was predominantly Northern European ancestry. About 90% of the people had this. There was only a minor contribution of Hispanic and other ethnicities. However, it's a large study done in the USA that did not demonstrate the blood group was associated with COVID-19 disease susceptibility or severity of COVID-19. For my viewers who wanted to know more about this important question, I hope it provides some further clarity for them. Thanks for watching me on my channel, Medicine with Dr. Moran, today. I'm Dr. Keith Moran. Remember, get healthy and stay healthy.